Hey y'all, it's Sunny with Mood Swing Barbecue. I'm here with B&B Charcoal today, and today I'm gonna show you a three-zone fire cook on a charcoal grill. What that means is we are going to have a hot direct side, a medium direct side, and an indirect heat source. All right, so today I'm gonna show you this beautiful tri-tip from Hassel Cattle Company. If you can see this, it has some amazing marbling in it. All of that fat is gonna render down and just create the most delicious flavor into this meat. So what I'm gonna start with is just lightly trimming it. I just wanna get that silver skin and that little bit of fat off that's not going to be delicious in that cut of meat. The easiest way to take a silver skin off is by taking the tip of your knife, just gently getting under that. It almost looks like a transparent skin. Just get under the edge of that, not deep into the meat. Gently pull it up, just like that, and then you can usually just pull it right off or slide your knife gently along the edge and it comes right off. Because that silver skin is not going to render down, it's also not gonna let any of your seasoning or anything get into the meat. Okay, and that's it. It's beautiful, not much to trim on this. So I'm gonna start by using an SPG, which stands for salt, pepper, garlic. So if you don't have Kosmo's SPG at home, you can easily just use salt, pepper, and garlic and layer them on there. You're gonna create pretty much the same flavor. Any type of beef handles salt, pepper, garlic really well. It enhances that beef flavor as it absorbs those, and you're gonna create that juicy, meaty beef flavor in your mouth. Next, I'm gonna top it off with a Kosmo's cow cover. It's just going to enhance the color and also provide a little bit more beef flavor to this dish. Okay, now I'm gonna let that rest so that the meat can, again, create the meat sweats and develop all of those flavors deep inside the meat. All right, now we're gonna start on our hasselback potatoes. What that means is we're going to actually cook these on the grill. Let me show you what it is. You cut partially the way down so that you can create more flavor inside the potato. It's also going to cook a little bit quicker than just baking it or throwing it, wrapping it in some tin foil and throwing it on the grill. So how to create this, I'm gonna take my knife and I'm just going to gently create little slices coming down. Now see on this end, like I had gone too far, so it's going to fall off. I don't want these to fall off. I want to be able to pull it with my knife so that I can use my basting brush and get my olive oil down in there. You can use butter, olive oil, whatever you want. I want to be able to butterfly it open, basically. So I can pull the different layers apart. What I like to do, instead of just using butter, I like to use olive oil, and I'll put some olive oil in a bowl. I have fresh garlic cloves here, and I like to crush them into the olive oil and create a garlic-infused olive oil that I'm going to baste in between each layer of this potato. The longer you let this olive oil and garlic sit, the more potent the flavor is going to be. But after it has set for a little bit, I'm just gonna take my basting brush, dip it in the oil and garlic mixture. Make sure you get a little bit of the garlic in there because that provides flavor. And I'm gonna go in between each of these slices and get the olive oil and garlic down in there. I don't know about you, but when I'm making a potato, I love the crispy skin on the baked potato. Well, this provides even more flavor deep down inside the potato, as well as more crisp around it by creating the slices. Okay, so you can see that I have little pieces of garlic on the potato. Now I'm gonna season it. I just have some plain sea salt, ground black pepper, garlic powder, you can never have enough garlic, and onion. Okay, so I'm gonna start with my salt because salt is gonna draw out the moisture in the potato as well as provide a little bit of flavor. I'm holding my layers apart when I'm applying these different seasonings, and I'm going very, very lightly. I don't want too much to get in there and be overpowering. You can use any kind of seasoning or flavorings that you like. We have played around with paprika, we've played around with chili powder, which is gonna add a little bit of kick. All different kinds of seasonings, parsley, basil, you're gonna get an Italian potato. All right, so these are ready. Now, I'm not just gonna put them on the grill because I don't want them to fall apart. I actually created little tin foil boats. I just took pieces of tin foil, I folded them into a little square and made a little boat, and I'm gonna place my potatoes inside. It's also, when they cook, it's also gonna provide a place for the olive oil to rest and create a nice crust all the way around the potato. I'm not gonna lose all that flavor. Just like that, super easy. All right, so in here I have the B&B briquettes that we are using. We are setting up our three zone cook right now. I'm gonna make a hot side, a medium side, and an indirect heat side that's not gonna have any charcoals on it. It's fully lit, it's ready to go, and we're gonna light this grill on fire. So as I set this up, after you dump your charcoal in, you're gonna wanna take your brush. I just want a few in the middle so that it creates just a little bit of heat for a middle in kind of indirect and direct heat side. I want a lot on one side that's going to create a direct sear for my tri-tip. And then I want a side that has nothing on it so that because I'm going to reverse sear this, I'm gonna bring it up to temperature first and then add that crust from the sear at the very end. All right, my grill is up to temp. So now we need to get the meat and potatoes on. I'm gonna place the potatoes right in the center over the medium heat. I don't want them over the direct heat to cook too fast, and I don't want them over indirect so that they don't crisp up. The tri-tip looks beautiful. It's been resting. So I'm actually going to do a reverse sear on this meat. I'm gonna stick it on the indirect side. I do not want to put it on the direct side. I want to slowly bring it up to temp so that that fat, all that marbling, just melts into the meat, creates that beautiful flavor that we're looking for, and creates a tender, juicy bite. Then, once it reaches 125, I'm going to throw it over to the direct side and sear it to create that nice, even crust that we all enjoy on our steak. Okay, so the tri-tip is ready to come off. I'm gonna let it rest a few minutes before I sear it. I want the temperatures to equal out. I don't wanna lose all the juices or anything like that. So I'm gonna check it. Put it in my half pan. I moved my potatoes over to the direct side. I want them to cook a little bit quicker now. They have been cooking a little bit slower. So I'm gonna let them ride while my tri-tip rests. All right, the potatoes are done. So I'm going to pull them off the grill and I'm gonna sear my tri-tip. You can hear the sizzling on the potatoes. That is all of that garlic olive oil that I have in there, and it's just helping give that extra flavor to the potatoes. So going back to my three zone cook, I have my indirect heat where I started the tri-tip over here. I have the medium where I started the potatoes, and I have my direct side right over here. I use the B&B Competition Blend Oak Briquettes, which is going to provide that nice smoky flavor of the oak onto this thick tri-tip. And I'm just going to sear it over the direct heat source. I'm just gonna let it sear on one side for about a minute, and then I'll flip it and do the same thing on the other side. All right, I have seared the first side. Let's flip it over and sear the second side. What this is doing is just creating that nice hard crust on the outside of the meat. It's gonna help seal in all of those juices and create that nice texture when you bite through it. All right, we have finished searing this tri-tip. Now I'm gonna let it rest before I cut it. I want it to retain all the juices and the moisture in the steak. All right, so we pulled the potatoes and the tri-tip off the grill. Let's serve them up. When I'm cutting my tri-tip, I like to cut across the grain. I can already feel by the knife that this is tender. Juices are coming out, so I know that the flavor is gonna be there. And I'm just gonna top it off with some beautiful green homemade chimichurri that I made using cilantro, parsley, garlic, a little bit of oregano, crushed red pepper, some lemon juice, red wine vinegar, and olive oil. If you can see how juicy this is coming out, and tender. Then to just top it off with a little bit of chimichurri, we'll take it over the top. I like to add it to my potatoes too. You don't need a lot, it's a lot of flavor. And there you have it. B&B charcoal used on a hasty bake grill today, making a beautiful reverse seared tri-tip hasselback potatoes with fresh chimichurri sauce.